Abandon Jesus, and ye shall receive power. This is your daily devotional reading.
Inspired by the Spirit, August 21st. The Publishing Work. And he said unto me, Thou must prophesy again before many peoples and nations and tongues and kings. Revelation 10 verse 11. Our publishing work was established by the direction of God and under His special supervision. It was designed to accomplish a specific purpose. Seventh-day Adventists have been chosen by God as a peculiar people separate from the world. By the great cleaver of truth, He has cut them out from the quarry of the world and brought them into connection with Himself. He has made them His representative and has called them to be ambassadors for Him in the last work of salvation. The greatest wealth of truth ever entrusted to mortals, the most solemn and fearful warnings ever sent by God to men, has been committed to them to be given to the world, and in the accomplishment of this work, our publishing houses are among the most effective agencies. These institutions are to stand as witnesses for God, teachers of righteousness to the people. From them, truth is to go forth as a lamp that burneth, like a great light in the lighthouse on a dangerous coast. They are constantly to send forth beams of light into the darkness of the world to warn men of the dangers that threaten them with destruction. The publications sent forth from our printing houses are to prepare a people to meet God. Throughout the world, they are to do the same work that was done by John the Baptist for the Jewish nation. By startling messages of warning, God's prophet awakened men from worldly dreaming. Through him, God called backsliding Israel to repentance. By his presentation of truth, he exposed popular delusions. In contrast with the false theories of his time, truth in his teaching stood forth as an eternal certainty. Repent ye, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, was John's message. Matthew 3 verse 2. This same message, through the publications from our printing houses, is to be given to the world today. Inspired by the Spirit, August 21st.